Hey, it's your boy, Adam Warrior the Isles, Challenger Coach, here to go over some of the new changes we have on patch 10.4. I'll be going over each jungle champion that was changed and doing a bit of theory crafting on how good they will be, what builds they might use, why you would pick them, or maybe why you shouldn't pick them. So with that out of the way, let's get right into it. To start off with, let's go over the new champions being introduced in the jungle. First up, we've got Dunkmaster Darius. Darius got his passive increased to 120% damage to monsters, and his Q now heals on monster hits. This should give him a decent clear speed in terms of healthiness and of course the speed, while also allowing him to solo neutral objectives kind of easily on his own. As for his setup, I could see him going in one of two ways with both of his items and his rune pages. For his items, you'll go Stalker's Blade pretty much every time as you'll need the extra mobility. After that, you can go Warriors with Trinity Force for hard carrying. But personally, I think of him more like set jungle, so I think Cinderhulk plus Black Cleaver into things like Dead Man's Plate is the way to go. Not to mention, he can easily proc the new passive with his E during a fight. For his runes, you could go Predator to give you better gank opportunities and give you a source of engage later on, but once again, he's pretty much just a worse version of set jungle, so Conquer with Sorcery Secondary for Water Walking Nimbus Cloak sounds really good. Almost no one's gonna be able to outduel him early on with this setup. Now, as for whether I think he's gonna be a good jungler, I think he'll do fine versus melee heavy comps, but he's definitely gonna struggle versus enchanter based range comps, and I would rank him probably around B tier, we'll have to see. If both Trundle and Set are banned, you could pick him up as a counter to tank junglers if, of course, you're an autofilled top laner looking to jungle, which I actually think is one of the main things Riot's trying to do with these jungle changes, just make it easier for that transition to actually jungling for low elo players, because let's face it, it's a really unpopular role at that level of play because the gate of entry is just so high. Next up, we got Garen, who received 150% damage to monsters on his E. He also got some other changes, which include Q's got a higher AD ratio, and W now increases bonus armor and MR by 10% when it's at max stacked. The shield amount also got changed, and all you really need to know about it is it's pretty much an overall buff for most of the game. Well, that just means that Garen in general received a massive buff to both of his damage and tankiness, while his E clear speed should be really fast, and due to his passive, he shouldn't really have trouble staying healthy in the jungle when you combine it with red buff health regen. For his setup, just like Darius, I feel like you can go two options. The first being Alien versus Predator as his keystone, while you can also take Water Walking and Nimbus Cloak, as it's pretty much the only way I feel like he can pull off ganks consistently, and you still got some good mid-game scaling with it. You could also go Conquer Primary as well to give you some more dueling and damage output. Itemization-wise, he really doesn't use the new Cinderhawk so well, and he scales pretty well off of AD, so I would recommend going Warriors and Stalker's Blade into Trinity Force Dead Man's Plate. It sounds pretty good to me, although you could also throw in a PD as a good option if you look to snowball. Just like Darius, he's just gonna be another top lane bruiser reject sent to the jungle, which is, you know, kinda sad because I remember back in the day it used to be jungle reject champions being sent to top lane, not the other way around. But either way, Garen jungle should be pretty decent at lower levels of play, at least as a gateway jungler. He's not really gonna be topping the meters in high low or anything like that, but at least he should be viable once people figure him out a little bit at lower levels of play. What makes me say that is Garen jungle will excel at power farming and outpacing the enemy. If the enemy jungler is a level 3 jungler like Lee Sin, he can match their dueling a little bit or at least survive while easily outscaling them during the mid game, similar to how old AD Shyvana worked. The next addition to the jungle will be Talon. Wait, seriously? Why would Riot do this to the community? Anyways, he received a passive bleed that now deals 120% damage to monsters. This might not seem like much, but it will help him clear large monsters faster as he doesn't really struggle to kill small ones due to his W. For his build, I can see him going the Shaco route or the Kha'Zix route. For the Shaco route, you can swap in Ignite over Flash to make his dueling really strong, and with his E and R, you really don't need Flash that much when you're a jungler. Then you can go Tiamat, Dustblade, Ghostblade, and skip the jungle item, kind of like Shaco does. With the Kha'Zix route, it's more standard. You're gonna take Flash, you're gonna go Warrior Red Smite, and then you're just gonna go Dustblade, Ghostblade, and whatever other lethality items you feel are appropriate at that point in time. For his runes, definitely go Electrocute, with secondary being pretty much preference, although you can't go wrong with Nimbus Cloak Water Walking, as you know, pretty much any jungler can take that and be perfectly fine right now. This champion to me though is gonna be another Shaco, where you're pretty much gonna get cheesed really hard by random invades early on, or by super unique gank pass to level 3, allowing him to snowball and one-shot the map after that like a normal mid lane Talon would. As far as playstyle, it's gonna play pretty much like a normal Talon since they barely lane to begin with, and I would see it being viable in solo queue, although at first, because there's a squishy assassin jungler who normally doesn't do well at low levels of play, I would cap him out at minimum maximum B tier, but this champion is broken in solo queue, so maybe once people find some new tech on him, maybe optimize his pathing, I could see him being a little bit better, but for now, definitely B tier max. Now this next change, I'm pretty excited about, bringing me back to the nostalgic days where people would chant Zetterbed in Burger King's Twitch stream, or when the word insect was more well known for the player rather than the Lee Sim players trying to do it and then, you know, die for fun. Fun fact though, Insect himself was a very prolific Zed jungle player, and it's not so much that Zed jungle was really strong back in season 3 or anything like that, it was just such a broken champion that you could jungle it anyways. With Riot deciding to revive it by giving his clear speed a boost due to energy restore on monsters as well as more passive damage on monsters to help his single target clear, it's gonna be pretty fun to watch people fail on it. Zed jungle back in the day and currently should excel at invading or dueling as he's got the mobility and burst, and unlike many melee junglers, he's got consistent poke damage with his shurikens to contest the enemy jungle with. On the downside, he's gonna be awful at scuttle control and neutral objective speed, but he will make up for it by having a fast clear speed, although it's not particularly healthy. His build is gonna be similar to Talon's. You're gonna go Red Smite Warriors as he is squishy and will need the extra dueling power, and you'll also follow that up with Dustblade, Ghostblade, or whatever other lethality items he needs. Runes, you would go Electrocute with Inspiration Secondary for free boots and CDR, although Precision Secondary for Coup de Grâce with Triumph or Presence of Mind sounds fine to me too. Now, do I think he's gonna be good in this particular tank jungle meta? Absolutely not. Maybe in future metas where tank junglers aren't the most OP thing in the world, he might make a comeback, but for now, definitely, he's more fun than he is good. Diana is probably the only one of these champions people play in the current jungle meta, and she's getting a buff to her AoE clear speed for good reason, because contrary to popular belief, her terrible sub 47% win rate does not actually mean she can be a jungler right now. These buffs should actually make her a passable jungle pick and help her reach the 50% marker if you're looking for an AP jungle assassin who's got fast clear speed and dueling and can actually teamfight, since Eve just doesn't cut it right now. For her build, I go Stalker's Blade with Runic Echoes and a Nashor's 2 Zhonya's as your core. It gives you a good mix of DPS, burst, and teamfighting potential. For her runes, I'd stick with Conqueror with Domination Secondary to help with damage and jungle sustain. As far as if I think she's gonna be good in the jungle, I'm not totally convinced that she's gonna be a top tier jungle pick compared to how OP she is in the mid lane, but she has seen some LCK play prior to the buffs, and I think out of all the junglers that are being added to the jungle pool this patch, I think she's the one that's closest to being a viable champion right off the bat. By now, you've probably likely noticed the trend is to just buff the clear speed on some champions in the hope that they'll actually be able to jungle, and that's no exception with Mordekaiser as he is getting a extra damage increase from his passive on monsters. Honestly though, I'm not totally convinced about his ability to jungle and his just jungle potential in general, because ever since they nerfed his passive damage, his 1v1 dueling, at least on low items versus full HP targets, just isn't amazing, and many jungle champions are either able to kite him or just dodge his Q. He'll have some okay post 6 ganks with his ultimate, which will actually be pretty decent, but his biggest strengths will be his clear speed. My issue with him in general from the jungle though is he's just a stat check champion, and with the reduced amount of XP in the gold and a worse item path because Runic Echoes just sucks on him, to be honest, I think he's just gonna be a worse champion from the jungle. For his build, I'd go Blue Smite Runic Echoes into Rally Zhonya, similar to his top build. For runes, Conqueror Domination secondary definitely is the way to go. I mean, it could be fun for top laners to pick him and lose on, but I'm not confident on his addition to being a jungler, and I think compared to Darius or Garen, he's definitely worse than them. Last up for new additions to the jungle, we've got Gnar, who I'm actually really interested in, because this pick is either gonna pop off once people learn it, or it's just gonna end up worse than the time people tried to convince me Nasus jungle was good because one YouTuber, not gonna name any names, had one good game on him after like 10 losses in a row. Gnar got a really good increase to his clear speed from his W, getting increased max damage to 300 right off the bat versus jungle monsters, but the big thing I'm wondering about with him is how important is it gonna be for him to actually transform at the right time? Will it be like properly choosing a TF card for the right situation, or is it gonna be like Aphelios where it doesn't really matter what weapon or transformation you have, it's gonna work out anyways? If it's like Aphelios, I think he'll be a fantastic jungler, able to invade or kite or run people down in mini Gnar form while having great dueling and scuttle control and ganks while in mega, while some really nice teamfighting and scaling will come in to boot after the laning phase. This is all just theory though, and any champion can be made to sound overpowered by just listing their strengths. The transformation is gonna be harder to control from the jungle and could cause his performance to be too random and inconsistent. With how hard it is to come back in the jungle right now, it might cause him to lose too many random games. I still think he's worth trying out though, and you would go Bloodraiser, Red Smite, Black Cleaver into Frozen Mallet or other tank items in general. For the runes, you'll likely want to go a lot of different options like PTA or Conqueror being fine, but I think Fleet Footwork makes the most sense to give him that extra kiting ability and chase down potential for duels or ganks, and I think his damage output will be fine even without PTA or Conqueror. Let's talk a little bit more about one of the biggest changes to the jungle meta this patch, and that's the gross overbuff of Cinderhulk. It now reads, while in combat, burns nearby enemies each second. Once every 10 seconds, your next immobilizing spell, pretty much just crowd control, will deal 12 to 29 plus 4% bonus HP and release a fire nova that's also going to deal damage around you, and increased to 300% to monsters and minions. When I read this at first, I was just dumbfounded. I made that stupid Pikachu mean face because I was like, what is this? Like, I know tank junglers are a little bit weak at the moment, but this just seems like a way too much and it's going to be way too strong. Because over the years, the normal weakness of a tank jungler is that their clear speed is lower and their dueling potential is lower to cover for the fact that they have way stronger late game, way stronger team fight, and way more utility. This is going to have a huge impact on the jungle meta because this kind of buff is going to make it so that they really don't have too much trouble dueling and they don't have too much trouble keeping up with farming. So with that in mind, I'm going to list off the champions that this is going to impact by how much and who it's going to be best on. We've got Trundle, Set, Volibear, Warwick, Zac, Charmander, Nunu, Rammus, Sejuani, Udyr, Gragas, and Amumu. In terms of impact, this won't be a big deal for Trundle and Set as they're already S tier, so it's just going to make them even stronger. Yay, everyone's super happy about that. Volibear and Warwick aren't tanks, but they will have a reliable way to proc the new Cinderhulk passive in duels, so I would see them moving up to S tier potentially, or at least be very high A tier for low elo. They're definitely going to be really strong because they're getting extra damage for doing pretty much nothing extra. Zac and Nunu are going to get a huge buff from this, and they can proc it multiple times a fight and during their jungle clear, so expect to see them have way more priority on both of these picks. Rammus and Udyr receive buffs on this patch and are both able to easily proc the Nova for super fast clears. Now, I know Udyr doesn't always take a tank route, but this is going to give him a viable path for him to actually go tank now and will give him a potential to actually go from B tier and maybe to A tier. Of course, if Trundle is banned, because both those champions are absolutely terrible versus him. J-Money or Charmander the 4th has in the past gone a tank route, and though I personally kind of hate seeing it, especially in competitive play, he can proc it pretty easily on camps. But of course, not as consistent on proccing the Nova from EQ on champions because they move around, although similar to Shen, if you're missing your EQ, you're probably going to lose that game anyway, so it could give him a different style of J4 that, you know, if you really need to go tank, you have that option. Gragas, similar to Amumu, who got some really nice buffs this patch, by the way, for his engage, are both champions who are currently built AP in the jungle, but in the past have had some tank builds, and with how strong Cinderhulk is at the moment, I could see, at the very least, Amumu returning to going tech, less so Gragas, but you never know. Sejuani, though not as good in solo queue as in competitive, will likely see an increase in professional picks as her clear speed is going to be a lot better, allowing her to outscale champions like Lee Sin pretty quickly. Overall, expect to see a lot more frontline champions in the jungle this patch, and do not underestimate the strength of the new Cinderhulk. That thing was so broken, it single-handedly pushed champions into S tier and needed to be immediately hotfixed on day 1. And even after the hotfix, it's still probably pretty broken. Before heading off to the last section, I'd like to point out some other champions that might enter the jungle that were not directly buffed by Riot. With the buffs to Cinderhulk, some tank junglers that were popular in the past might make a comeback. These include Ornn, Cho'Gath, Shen, Nautilus, Skarner, Sion, or Maokai. With the increase in clear speed and damage, the utility that these champions bring could be valuable from the jungle, as none of these champions require a lot of gold or XP to function properly, so they could be worth testing out. Out of all of them, the ones I'm confident in are Ornn and Cho'Gath, mostly because Ornn is pretty busted in general right now, so I think you could probably pick a AD carry and still do fine, and Cho'Gath is a good anti-tank tank coming into a tank meta. I'm also personally partial to Shen, but you know, I can't realistically recommend him or think he's actually going to be good or anything, but you know, it could be fun to test out, but if you're looking for something off-meta to try out on 10.4, some of these could be worth your time. As some of you may know, sometimes I do a TLDR at the end of my videos, but this time around, I think I'll do it in a bit more of an interesting fashion. What I did was make a quick rankings chart of what I think each new jungler edition will rank in some of the most important skills a jungler could have, which include ganking, clear speed, dueling, scaling, neutral objective control, invade potential, and team fighting. There are of course other skills like scuttle wrangling that are important, but these are the core of what a jungler wants. I've ranked each champion from 1 to 5, 5 being the highest and 1 being the lowest, and then compared them to some of the S tier champions in each category from our current low elo S tier, and then Lee Sin of course because he's the embodiment of the jungle. Now, disclaimer about the rankings, these aren't meant to be taken as gospel, and some of them can be argued and changed by 1 point. This rankings list isn't meant to be exact, and it's more of a way to give you a rough visualization of what the new junglers' potential and what they are capable of compared to already established ones, so please do not massacre me over these in the comment sections. It is simply to help understand their place in the jungle a bit better before any real data comes in. One thing to note is currently almost all of the new jungle additions are doing really bad stat-wise, which I believe to be partly due to improper setups and playstyle combined with being slightly too weak to begin with. Who knew just taking random top laners and giving them slightly more clear speed wasn't going to make them a true jungle champion. That's it for our video on the new jungle champions and changes on 10.4. Thanks everyone for watching, and please make sure to check out our other content on this YouTube channel or on our website at mobilex.gg. I'm Adam Moriarty-Isles, and hopefully I'll see you out on the Rift.